Welcome to Scoop Canada, where we expose the realities that the Trudeau government would rather keep hidden. Today, we're diving into a deeply troubling issue that has been downplayed and obscured from public view, a matter that strikes at the very heart of our democracy. It's astonishing, really, how this government has kept Canadians in the dark. A recent memo from the RCMP reveals that foreign actors are not just meddling from afar, but are actively carrying out interference within our borders. The document plainly states that these foreign threats include the harassment of individuals and groups within Canada. Yet, instead of confronting this head-on, the Trudeau government appears complicit, using this interference to secure their electoral success. This isn't just a minor oversight, it's a gross betrayal of the trust Canadians place in their leaders. Every Canadian has the right to a government that protects their interests, yet what we're seeing here is a government more interested in protecting its own power. Trudeau has been hiding the truth from Canadians, shielding his government's failures behind a wall of secrecy. The reality is stark: foreign interference is real. It's happening right here in Canada, and it's being swept under the rug by a Liberal government that doesn't want you to know the full story. This isn't just a lapse in judgment, it's a deliberate attempt to keep Canadians in the dark, to maintain a facade of control while our democratic foundations are being eroded. This raises a serious question: how can Canadians trust a government that won't even acknowledge the threats against them? Trudeau's lack of transparency on this issue is not just negligent, it's dangerous. We're talking about a government that is willing to compromise national security for its own political gain, a government that would rather stay in power than protect the very citizens it is supposed to serve. It's time to demand accountability. The Trudeau government must be held responsible for its role in downplaying these threats and hiding the truth from Canadians. This isn't just about politics, it's about the safety and security of every person living in this country. We deserve better. And it's high time we got it. The Trudeau government's approach to foreign interference and the flow of illegal substances like fentanyl into Canada is a stark reminder of how disconnected they are from the real threats facing Canadians. While acknowledging China's efforts to curb the production and distribution of illegal substances globally, the reality remains that China is still a major source of precursor chemicals used to produce fentanyl domestically. This is a substance that has ravaged communities across Canada, leading to an opioid crisis that has claimed countless lives. Despite these known threats, Trudeau's government seems more interested in paying lip service than taking concrete action to protect Canadians. They claim to take foreign interference seriously, yet the evidence suggests otherwise. The expired Memorandum of Understanding MU between the RCMP and China's Ministry of Public Security MPS is a glaring example. This MU, once a tool for cooperation on law enforcement issues of mutual concern, remains expired with no plans for renewal in the immediate future. Why? Because the Trudeau government is unwilling to navigate the complexities of the Canada-China relationship in a way that prioritizes the safety and security of Canadians. This reluctance to act is not just negligence, it's a deliberate choice. By downplaying the threats and failing to renew vital agreements, Trudeau's government is effectively leaving Canadians exposed to ongoing foreign interference and the continued flow of dangerous drugs like fentanyl. It's as if they are more concerned with maintaining a facade of diplomacy than actually addressing the pressing issues at hand. Before we move further, discover our exclusive collection of mugs, hoodies, and a variety of daily accessories designed for Canada Conservative Party supporters. Show your pride with our conservative-themed products at affordable prices. Enjoy free delivery across Canada. What's even more disturbing is the broader context of foreign interference. The RCMP has acknowledged that foreign actor threats and interference are actively being carried out in Canada, including the harassment of individuals or groups. Yet, the Trudeau government has done little to reassure Canadians that they are protected from these threats. Instead, they've allowed this interference to continue unchecked, seemingly as a necessity for their electoral success. The truth is, Trudeau has been hiding the reality of these threats from Canadians. By refusing to take decisive action against foreign interference and failing to address the root causes of the opioid crisis, his government has shown a blatant disregard for the safety and well-being of the people they are supposed to serve. This is not just a failure of leadership, it's a betrayal of the trust that Canadians have placed in their government. The time for empty words and half-hearted measures is over. Canadians deserve a government that will take real action to protect them from foreign interference and the deadly flow of drugs into our communities. Trudeau's refusal to confront these issues head-on is a clear indication that his priorities lie elsewhere, leaving Canadians to bear the brunt of his inaction. This is yet another example of how the Trudeau government has failed to live up to its promises, and it's time for Canadians to demand better. A report by the Financial Post reveals yet another desperate move by Justin Trudeau's government, this time casting Chinese electric vehicle EV producers as an extraordinary threat to Canada's auto and metal workers. The press release from Trudeau's administration claims that these sectors, which reportedly support around 255,000 jobs, are under siege due to China's non-market economy and its so-called poor environmental and labor standards. But let's be real, this is just Trudeau's latest ploy to distract from his own government's economic shortcomings. In a move that reeks of political grandstanding, Trudeau announced a 25% surtax on imports of steel and aluminum from China, effective October 15th. He also hinted that similar measures could soon target Chinese-made solar panels and semiconductors. This follows in the footsteps of U.S. President Joe Biden, who slapped 100% tariffs on Chinese-made EVs back in May. But does anyone really believe this will solve Canada's deep-seated economic issues? Or is this just another knee-jerk reaction from a government that's increasingly out of touch with the realities faced by Canadian workers? Deputy Prime Minister Chrystia Freeland, never one to shy away from pointing fingers, accused China earlier this summer of violating international trade rules by deliberately overproducing EVs to flood foreign markets with cheap exports. She even launched a 30-day consultation on the matter in early July, as if that would somehow counteract China's well-established dominance in the EV industry. But here's the kicker: while Trudeau and Freeland are busy blaming China, they're conveniently ignoring their own government's failure to foster a competitive EV industry within Canada. For years, the federal and provincial governments, especially in Ontario and Quebec, have thrown tens of billions of dollars at automakers and battery producers in the form of tax credits, loans, and direct investments. The goal: to lure these companies into building an EV supply chain in Canada. But now, as China's more mature and efficient EV industry ramps up production, fears are growing that all those Canadian investments will be undermined by cheaper Chinese imports. And who's to blame for that? Certainly not China. The real culprit here is Trudeau's government, which has consistently failed to create a business environment that could compete on a global scale. So while Trudeau and his ministers are busy issuing tariffs and making grandiose claims about protecting Canadian jobs, the reality is much bleaker. The very same government that has pledged billions to support the auto and battery industries is now scrambling to save face as their poorly conceived economic strategies begin to unravel. Instead of taking responsibility for their own failures, they're pointing the finger at China, a convenient scapegoat, but not the real problem. Also, take a minute to visit our website, sign the petition demanding Justin Trudeau leave the office immediately, and sign up for our newsletters to get uncensored news in Canadian politics. And do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more updates. It's high time we saw through this charade. Trudeau's tariffs might make for good headlines, but they do nothing to address the underlying issues facing Canada's economy. In fact, they may even exacerbate them. As China continues to dominate the global EV market, Canada is left playing catch-up, with the government more interested in scoring political points than in enacting meaningful economic reforms. In the end, it's Canadian workers who will pay the price for Trudeau's incompetence. The jobs he claims to be protecting are still at risk, not because of China, but because of his government's failure to create a competitive and sustainable economic environment. So the next time Trudeau or Freeland tries to blame China for Canada's economic woes, remember this: the real threat to Canadian jobs isn't on the other side of the world, it's right here in Ottawa. Stay tuned to Scoop Canada as we continue to bring you the latest on this developing story. Trust us, this is one scandal you won't want to miss.